The crisis season in APC is not over as a faction of the National Working Committee insists that the next meeting attended by President Muhammadu Buhari is illegal. And from APC to PDP, Governor Godwin Obaseki wins the PDP primary in Edo State. This is Plus Politics. I am Kayode Ladeinde. Members of the All Progressive Congress National Working Committee from Adams Oshiomhole's camp have insisted that the APC National Executive Committee meeting attended by President Muhammadu Buhari was illegal. They have stated that they are consulting their lawyers and other stakeholders on the dissolution of the NWC and other decisions taken at the next meeting on Thursday. Our question is, When will this battle end, or will it keep spreading to other chapters of the ruling party? Joining us to discuss this is Gbola Oba, public affairs analyst, who is joining us via Zoom, and we also have Henry Idahagbon, former commissioner for justice in Edo State, joining us via phone. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening. Thanks for having me.
Good evening.
Yeah, let me start with Mr. Bola Oba. Looking at what happened yesterday, as much as a lot of interpretations, a whole lot of reactions have greeted that decision, what's your assessment? Let me just give you the first 60 seconds to give me your reaction on that.
My assessment as the chair is that the waters seem to have settled ostensibly, but behind the visible, behind the ostensible peace.
Let me quickly get Henry, since that is a full line. What's your reaction? I remember on this program, you stated your position and your full support for the NWC that was dissolved. Are you okay with that political solution the president seems to have preferred?
Well, in politics, you must always expect the unexpected. There are always a lot of twists and turns. We didn't expect that neck meeting, and we didn't expect the NWC to be dissolved the way it was done. But talking strictly about law, of course, that neck meeting was illegal, and the method for the dissolution of the NWC is definitely illegal. But I will not advise the NWC members to go to court. This is more of a political problem that requires a political solution than a legal solution. All the NWC members came from different states. A Congress committee has been set up. We have our Congress. They can go back to their respective states and contest and win. As for our former national chairman, I believe he has acquitted himself very well. He will go down in history as one of the best national party chairmen we have ever had in this country. He brought a lot of seriousness. He brought a lot of verve. He brought a lot of discipline. He was audacious. And of course, as national chairman, you cannot be successful without stepping on toes, if not even chopping off toes.
Okay.
So I'm not surprised, for example, that some persons have rejoiced since his ouster yesterday. I saw the comical video made by Senator Dilu Melaye, who I believe is my friend, and I like him. Taunting Oshiomhole in that video, it is normal. Oshiomhole had fought a lot of battles. You win some, you lose some, and that's the way life is.
Okay.
So
we will come back to you.
I think the NWC should look for a political solution rather than approaching
a legal solution.
Court.
Okay, we'll come back to that. I like the way you opened the conversation, but let me go back to Bola Oba. I understand the network is better now. So please, can we go back to you making your opening remark on this discourse?
Oh, like I was saying, ostensibly the waters are, you know, are settled, but we know that the animosities, jealousies, the factional, the internecine war are still there, just concealed. So, and listening to the gentleman who just spoke now, it is obvious that he is one that is a supporter of the Oshiomhole reign, but there are so many APC members out there too who genuinely believe that Oshiomhole was an irritant and was more of a disruptor of the mechanism and the machinery of the party, and that ultimately, because under him, states like Cross River, states like Rivers, Zamfara, were lost to as a result of poor political management of the party, and that even Edo now is the jury is still out on Edo. So I'm sitting there thinking, not being a partisan of the APC and not even being a partisan of any of the opposition parties to the APC, I empathize with Oshiomhole, because I've always said, whilst all those troubles were brewing and were in place, I've always said that Oshiomhole inherited a party that was mismanaged fundamentally. And you know what? The wife of the wife of a gullible husband is usually seen to be high-handed, to be tough by members of the family. Those who were riding roughshod over the party before Oshiomhole assumed leadership felt that his coming disrupted their activities.
Okay.
So, but it's no longer there now. Let's see how the party moves on.
Okay, you've actually spoken like an analyst, but I'm sure I'll get to know your position soon. Now, you mentioned something. Let me go back to Henry. You mentioned something quite, quite controversial. You said everybody should move on and all is well. The discordant tune we're hearing is that of, excuse me, I haven't finished my tenure. I was duly elected. I was duly inaugurated. What is the ground? The next meeting itself, according to them, was a nullity. Why should they just, you know, give in to the dissolution?
Well, please, before I answer your question directly, let me remind my colleague who just spoke. He said something that to the effect that Oshiomhole is responsible for the loss of the Zamfara and River State. I think it is important we set the record straight. If he was in this country and he followed the events that led to the elections in Zamfara State being nullified, and if he had read the court judgments, he will know that Oshiomhole has no blame whatsoever. We had a recalcitrant governor in Zamfara State then who thought he was Lord and Master unto himself. He did not allow the National Working Committee members sent to his state to conduct primaries. Instead, he conducted his own primaries at the state level and fielded all the candidates for election. I remember very well then, he threatened that should Oshiomhole enter Zamfara State, it is his body that will be taken out of the state. Of course, the law is clear. It is only the NWC that has responsibility for the conduct of primaries. And INEC will only accept names of candidates sent to it by the national chairman of a political party. And because of that, the recalcitrant governor, we lost all the entire seats in Zamfara State. The same scenario played out in River State. So you cannot hold Oshiomhole responsible for the recalcitrance of other people.
Mr. Henry, before I allow him to respond, let's also look at the argument there. Like you said, According to him, the jury is out. A lot of people have started doing assessment of Oshiomhole's tenure. How many yes. states have been lost during the general election? They've also yes. reminded us that, good, he may be a disciplinarian, but he yes. could be diplomatic about it. Don't you think that's, yes. that's the weakness he has?
Okay, I will compare Oshiomhole's tenure as chairman of APC to the tenure of President Muhammadu Buhari when he was a military general and when he ran, when he ruled this country with Tunde Idiagbon.
Okay.
A lot of Nigerians were not comfortable, but they sought to bring discipline to the country. When you are in a public place, you want to assess public service, you have to queue up. Something as simple as queuing up, Nigerians have to be forced to do it. So Oshiomhole had to bring discipline to the party. The party was mismanaging, said so, and I agree with him. He had to bring discipline to the party. He should be given credit for that okay. and not be vilified.
Good.
Before Oshiomhole, the party's ship was just running okay. adrift on the ice. There was no direction.
Mr.
There was no purpose.
Idagbon, you know, but it's a conversation, so let's hear the other party.
Okay. Can
we look at the merit of Oshiomhole as outlined by Mr. Idagbon? He has no apology that is an Oshiomhole sticker. But what exactly is your grouse with Oshiomhole's time? That's, I'm talking about Bola Oba now.
I have no grouse with Oshiomhole's style. I hope you too, as the anchor, the moderator of this thing, you are not just interested in stoking controversy.
Not at
you
all.
You know, with the gentleman, I have no grouse with Oshiomhole, and I have no grouse with what the gentleman may have presented. But if he is a lawyer, like you've introduced him, he will agree with me that chronicles, historical accounts, don't go into the Manuche as it has gone into the Manuche. It should be recorded that Zamfara and Rivers were lost under Oshiomhole, that he was trying to instill discipline, that he could not get the handle well, that he was relating with some recalcitrant characters or some megalomaniacal characters or vaultingly ambitious characters. History will not go too much into those details. Those two states were lost under him in manners that, in fact, three states. Because you know what? They won an electoral victory in Elsa, but unfortunately, as a result of a jurisprudential coup d'etat, like, because what the Supreme Court did in Bayelsa, for me, stands as an embarrassment to a robust liberal democracy. But having said that, still on record, it was a loss under Oshiomhole. So whether the gentleman likes it or he doesn't like it, you know, those are historical facts now.
Okay.
But as a person, I've got no issue with Oshiomhole. It was just that the party, the former chairman of the party, was a man who didn't have his hands well on the handle. And unfortunately, I'm just being a bit polite, unfortunately, you have a president like President Muhammadu Buhari, who only is agile on matters affecting his own political career and cared less about the party until the dramatic move he made day before yesterday, which was in itself a move based on illegality to write a lingering and festering wound that if he knew he was going to intervene ultimately, that he could have corrected long ago before the illegality that he rode on to correct it
okay.
yesterday.
Mr. Bolaba, for clarity, what you're saying in essence is you believe that net meeting was a nullity, but the solution appears okay in terms of politics. Do you believe that the political solution was in order?
My friend, there's a difference between politics and realpolitik. If you know the meaning of realpolitik, you will know that what happened yesterday was more of realpolitik than politics. Politics is nearer to the rule of law. Realpolitik sometimes could be very distant from the rule of law. What happened yesterday was an illegality that was legitimized by the presence of the president. If the president was not there, somebody like the gentleman who is my colleague on this show now will probably be filing suit on behalf of some people, especially Oshiomhole.
Okay, good. Mr. Idaabon, is it okay to suggest, since I'm not stoking any fire, is it okay to suggest that the reason why you're okay with the president and the NEC decision yesterday was because at least you, the primaries in Edo State was ratified?
Well, let me say that I agree that the NEC meeting was illegal, and I agree that the dissolution of NWC was also illegal. And the reason why both actions are illegal is because they failed to follow the constitutional provisions. You require a minimum of 14 days to summon NEC meetings. An emergency meeting of NEC is 7 days. This notice period was not adhered to. But what I am saying, and that's the difference between me and Mr. Gbolaha, you have introduced him as an analyst. I am not an analyst. I am a practicing politician,
okay,
a grassroots politician, and I have no apology to make. I am saying, inasmuch as I do not agree with Mr. President's action, legally, the president has moral authority to do what he did, and that moral and political authority we should respect.
Okay.
And we should move on, because the party had so many centripetal and centrifugal forces that were prepared to drag the party in the mud. People like Vitor G. Adom, they were people like him, were fifth columnists interested in dragging the party to the mud. Now we have a new opportunity to start afresh. And in that emergency convention, we will elect new officers and we will start afresh.
Okay.
So, after history.
Just to answer my question, is it born out of the fact that your candidate primaries was ratified, probably in a few seconds?
I am happy that the primary was ratified.
Okay.
Because we have a vibrant and viable candidate that will retain the governorship seat for the party in the state. But that is not the only reason.
Okay.
I am talking now as a politician, qua politician.
No apology on that. Thank you so much.
No apology whatsoever.
To be honest with you,
before you respond, can we now look at the conversation out there? Let me go back to Gbola Oba. Can we also consider the conversation out there that this is beyond Oshiomhole, Giadom, that there are some hands behind this, in quotes, actors? Do you share that sentiment?
Oh, actually, everybody knows that if you're a student of the Nigerian political environment and if you're a follower of the Nigerian political environment, you know that Oshiomhole, Victor Giadom are just two characters who are proxy, who are being used, two personages who are being used as the faces of latent forces in the party trying to control the machinery of the party for 2023. Everybody knows that. You know what? Oshiomhole is somebody's boy. Everybody knows that. Victor Giadom is somebody's boy. Everybody knows that. You know, we have the Ashima, we have the Bola Ahmed Tinubu wing that Oshiomhole is seen to be tooling for. We have the Rotimi Amechi wing of a faction of the party that everybody knows Victor Giadom to be tooling for. When I say tooling, as I mean being used as tools. But having said that, I need to quickly make this point too. And the point is that the party should not be celebrating yet, because the circumstance that legitimized the gubernatorial candidature of Eze Iyamo yesterday may still be a subject of litigation up to the Supreme Court. Because on the one hand, as a result of the support the president gave Victor Giadom day before yesterday to let that next meeting be constituted yesterday, it would ordinarily to have legitimized the letter that Victor Giadom wrote to INEC that he did not, as this as the actual man then, he did not support the shadow election that took place in Benin for the emergence of Eze Yamu as the candidate of the party.
I'm really running out of time. I'll come back to you. I just have 40 seconds for both of you to make your final submission on this. Mr. Henry Idahagbon, you seem so confident as a party man that the party is moving forward. Is that 100%?
Yes, we are moving forward. Politics is about the resolution of conflict. We have resolved one yesterday. Other ones will come up, we will resolve it.
Okay.
My party was, Oshomole has done well as National Party Chairman. He will come back to Edo State for a hero's welcome. He did well as Governor of Edo State. He did well as Secretary of Nigerian Labour Congress. He did well as President of Nigerian Labour Congress. He has today acquitted himself as one of the best chairman of a national political party in this country. You may like him, you may hate him, it doesn't really matter. These are facts. And history will be on the right side of history.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you for your time. And let me get Gbola Oba's summary.
My closing remark would be advice to the APC in Edo State. If they really like themselves, they shouldn't let Oshiomhole be involved in the electioneering campaigns of Eze Yamu. And the reason is that the Obaseki side are looking for any sentiment that they could hold on to want to start lie to the Edo electors, the electorate, that they are only trying to decapitate a godfather. That is the reason for the motive for their contestation. They should, Edo APC should be very careful not to let Obaseki exploit that opportunistic campaign strategy.
Thank you so much, Mr. Gbola Oba. We will wait whether APC will listen to that advice or they will ignore it. Thank you for your time, Bola Oba, a public affairs analyst. And once again, thank you to Henry Idahagbon, former commissioner for justice in Edo State. Thank you for staying with us. Our viewers, we will take a short break. We are not done yet. And when we return, we'll be looking at Obaseki's victory in PDP. That is up for discussion. Please don't go anywhere.